start talking more about dupes on my channel. I know a lot of people are interested in the topic of dupes because there's so many expensive products that come out and we don't always want, oh my gosh, we don't want to be dropping the amount of money that cosmetics companies would like us to drop every month, which I'd say it's probably around 1,000. What do we think, 1,000? I think that's a good guess. So in today's video, I want to talk to you guys about some drugstore dupes for the Stila Glitter and Glows. These are phenomenal products and so many people love them because of their quality and how they wear and how gorgeous they are. But what I'm holding in my hand here was over $100 with tax. They're expensive. So I've got four drugstore dupes to talk about in this video that range from $4.99 each to $10.99. Now with this particular video, I need to tell you, I hate intros, I hate watching them, and I hate filming them, but I need to have a short one. Whenever you are talking about dupes on YouTube, I've noticed that this is a very tense topic. And I kind of already gave the reason as to why. It's that, you know, makeup is so expensive, people want to be able to find some more affordable options. The problem that I see is that even with this video, some of these were highly recommended from YouTube videos that I watched, and I kind of disagree. I tend to be a very blunt person, and you're either gonna love or hate this fact, but because of this, I can't sit here and rave that something is a dupe when in my mind it isn't. And I think that where this gets really complicated is you start getting into kind of issues of classism. You know, do you really wanna sit behind a camera and tell a bunch of people whose income you do not know that a product that's $25 is something you must have and the $5 item is not good? Do you really wanna say that? Because that is kind of eliminating a lot of people. So it seems like there's a default phrase to use to kind of clear yourself of concerns over classism or quality of the product, and that's the phrase, good for the money. I hate that phrase, and I will not use it ever. And the reason for this is because the phrase, good for the money, does not tell you anything about the product. When you say good for the money, you are saying good for the money, which means you're actually reviewing our economic structure. You're saying what $5 is compared to $25 and completely sidestepping the product in question entirely. I'm forced to think that's just an easy way out, an easy way to kind of please everybody rather than to be honest. I'm gonna be honest, and my opinion's not going to be the most probably favored, but I feel it's more important to review the product quality and to avoid creating the situation of classism. I do have dupes at the end of this video that are not these that I think are as good as the Stila Glitter and Glows. But let's start talking about these drugstore dupes, and we'll go in order of what I think is best to worst. Number one is going to be the Essence Metal Shock Eyeshadow. This is $4.99, and this is what I'm wearing today. I'm actually wearing a full face of drugstore makeup minus the lipstick, which I think is pretty neat. This whole eye look cost me $15 total. The mascara is from Wet n Wild. I think it was $6 or $7. So it's a fairly affordable look, and this is indeed a good product. However, I don't think it is a dupe for the Stila Glitter and Glows. It may be a dupe for the Stila Shimmer and Glows, and I'm about to show you why. So this color that I own is the shade 1 Second to Mars, and I'm gonna swatch it up against the Stila Rose Gold. So I will put up the swatches that I'm looking at so that you can see them more clearly. What I want you to notice is that in terms of texture, they actually look really quite similar. The Stila does blend out better, and that's gonna be something I'm gonna say throughout this entire video. The Stila blends beautifully, and you know, I think that's a huge reason why it's hit such a cult status. However, you get about the same amount of shimmer with the Essence, but you don't get any glitter. And you know, these are Glitter and Glows. There's always glitter in them, and to me, that's what draws me in. There is an entire line of Shimmer and Glows. I don't own any of them, but I highly suspect that this is gonna be closest to that. You know, it's a very beautiful finish. It actually reminds me a lot of the Cover FX veils as well, the shimmer veils. I did notice you have to build this up more than the Stila's. But even in terms of application, it's got that nice doe foot applicator. And before I move on, I don't want to forget to mention the wear time of these. I do think this wears exceptionally well. I don't notice any glitter fallout, but again, that could be because there's not much glitter in them. However, in terms of seeing patchiness throughout the day, You see a little bit, but it's something that you would really only notice if you were very close to somebody. It's not enough for me to say that it really detracts from the product. It's just you will get a little bit of creasing. And so honestly, with all of these, even though they're supposed to be eyeshadow and primer all infused into one, I would still recommend a primer with all of them. Next, I want to talk about the Flower Warrior Glitter Shadow. This is a new release and it is $10.99. Now, I've bought a lot of Flower Beauty's products and, you know, I guess I just think they're kind of hit or miss. I really, truly love the primer, wearing it again today. But as for this glitter shadow, let me swatch it. I spent a lot of time trying to decide which of these to purchase, and something that I noticed personally, I bought the shade Camo because that is the one that seemed to be the least patchy. The others actually looked a lot like the next products I'm going to be talking about, but for more than double the price. So it was pretty easy for me to end up picking Camo. You do see some glitter chunks in this. I'm gonna swatch it next to, I don't have a Stila shadow that is like this, so I guess I'll just swatch it next to Diamond Dust. It's almost an unfair comparison because this is the most glittery of the Glitter and Glows that I own, but this is also a fairly glittery eyeshadow. I think it does look very pretty upon initial application. It does end up being a little bumpy on the lids, for lack of a better description. It's almost like the product kind of builds up on itself. But again, in many ways, I think this is more approaching the look of a Glitter and Glow than the Essence Metal Shock that I just talked about. So why did I put this number 2 in my list? It's solely because this one flakes on me, like, whoa. I've worn this twice now, and both times, within 30 minutes of applying it, I have lost a chunk of it directly where my lid kind of folds, which, okay, maybe that's my eyelid's fault, sure, but if Stila's Glitter and Glows can hold up to me blinking all day like a, you know, normal human being, then I would like this $10.99 eyeshadow to do the same. Especially because, you know, it is $10.99. It's $10.99. That's not that cheap. And I haven't yet really found a way to make this work for me. I think the best option that I've found is to just use it in the outer corner of your lids. But that's not why I bought it. I bought it to use the same way that I use these, which is all over the lid. And because it creases so badly, I can't say it's a dupe. I cannot say it. So I was really quite disappointed in this, especially because it's $10.99 and because I bought it with my points, so I can't return it to Ulta. But I did want to share that, and considering that everybody has said this is the best one, I'm inclined to say probably I would not recommend purchasing from this entire range. I've got two left, and they're from Wet n Wild. So I'm just gonna group these together because I'm not really sure if there's a big difference between these. One is from the Gothographic collection, and it is called the Liquid Catsuit Eyeshadow. And one is the Color Icon Metallic Liquid Eyeshadow from the Mermaid collection. I dislike both of these because they do the exact same thing on my lids as the last product I was talking about. I'm going to swatch both of these next to Sea Siren. These are both $4.99, and I want them to be amazing because the price is amazing. But I have the same issue with this darker color, the Color Icon Metallic Liquid Eyeshadow. It just flakes at the crease. It seems that the formula is incapable of holding up on the eyelid. The Liquid Catsuit still creases on me, but my problem with this one is that it's very patchy. It takes a lot of this in order to build it up so that it's visible on your eyelid. And again, you know, even if it's just $5, you don't really want to pay $5 for something that you can barely see. I get the feeling that I'm not the only one who felt this way, since I'm actually really getting into Wet n Wild these days. I bought the latest collection. I'm hoping to get a video up on this one soon. And I've noticed that this and the last collection, they did skip on doing these eyeshadows. So maybe they're taking it to the drawing board and working on it, coming out with something better. But for now, I would say that these are not close to a dupe. It just kind of leaves you really wanting more. And that's what I dislike so much about suggesting dupes that are not good quality, is they still leave you wanting. And in the end, that's how you can end up spending initially $5 and initially $10, and then you end up buying this anyway, so now you spent $34 instead of $24. So at this point, basically what I'm saying is that I don't think any of these are dupes for the Stila Glitter and Glows, but I'm not going to leave this video without giving you some options. So let me start with an old standby, something that we have been doing since the 80s, the 90s. I don't know how far back this goes, but a glitter primer such as the one from NYX, which is $6.99, and a loose glitter. This is what I have personally done to stop myself from buying the entire Stila Glitter and Glow collection. I don't need to spend $500 in Stila glitters. Nobody does. All you need to do is get a good glitter primer, and trust me, this NYX one is amazing. Make sure you buy eye safe glitters. This is really important, and actually NYX kind of got me on this one. I didn't know that their face and body glitters are only three shades are eye safe. I will list those for you so you don't make the same mistake I did. You really don't want to use non-eye safe glitters on your eyes. Oh my gosh, please don't. But that is a great option. The con with doing that is that you will want to buy some panty liners as well for your face. You think I'm kidding for a second? I'm not kidding. Not for a second. And then my final suggestion is one that I actually made a video on over a year ago. This is the Pure Eye Polish Glitters. These retail for $31 for five. So it's a little more of an initial investment, but for whatever this is worth, somebody mentioned seeing these at TJ Maxx or Marshall's, and if so, if you can pick up five of these for $15 or so, that is a very good deal. But there is a con with these, and that is the packaging. I absolutely hate this little wand on them. It's this spatula thing, which makes them terrible to apply, so you will want to transfer these to a brush. But I will go ahead and put up a swatch so you can see. You can barely tell a difference on the lid. I will say that the Stila, I have that one, the one that I have up is the Stila Rose Gold next to one of these. And you can still see there's a bit more glitter with the Stila, but it is the closest that I have found. I don't hear people talk about these too much, and I think it's just that I don't think anybody quite knows what to do with Pure as a brand. They're this very odd in-between. They're not high-end, really, but they're not drugstore, really. It's, what are they? Best friends with BoxyCharm, I guess, but what else? I don't know. So I hope you guys did find this video helpful. Please let me know if you like this video, if you like the idea of me talking more about dupes, by hitting either like or dislike. That guides me into what videos to make. And worth noting, if you are interested, I will start that series up as soon as I finish the true cost of makeup. That last video should be up next Monday or Tuesday. This last video's been a lot more research than I anticipated. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace out, YouTube.